There we go.
Okay, Keldon. Keldonio.
How you doing?
I'm doing great, man. This place sounds familiar.
Yeah. We finally get to hang out here, not playing or working or doing anything like that. So.
Yeah. Is it work or not? It is a lot of work.
It is a lot of work, but it's something. I mean, I love it, so it's fun for me.
And I can't complain either. I get to hang out with everybody. I've done it for a long time, and I'm still around after 21 years.
Yeah.
So it's always fun to be here. Well, for you, this is fifth?
My fifth year.
Fifth year.
Yes, sir.
For me, it's 21st. And I remember getting here for the first time and being like in awe, like shocked. It was brand new.
Yeah.
So the first time that I got here, it was just, we were making the first baskets here. So I was very, very impressed and fired up to come here and start working out,
getting
to meet David Robinson and Tim Duncan. For me, it was crazy. But I guess for you, something like that happened too, right?
Yeah, it was like a dream come true for me, at least. I feel like I was so nervous to first see Pop.
Oh yeah, Pop.
Yeah,
obviously an intimidating one.
Yeah, I never knew really what to expect because the media can portray him as one thing, but
and then he is.
Yeah,
he's exactly that, right?
Yeah, but I feel like he's great, man. He's great. Oh, it was the first training camp. My first buckets here. It was all great. For me personally, I feel like I wouldn't want to do it any other way than how I did it here. So, what was your nickname? What do you first think of you?
I was called a lot of things. I don't know if you can say they were nicknames, but I was called a lot of things. Tony and me, we got some names can't really repeat. And we were intimidated too. But Pop was not the Pop is now.
Yeah.
2003, he won one championship. So he wasn't a legend yet.
Yeah.
He was still scary and he was still crazy. But we wanted to be here so bad and we wanted to learn and improve and try to get one of those that, with Tim, that we were willing to, sacrifice and do everything for him.
That chemistry, like in the locker room, like how was the locker room for like a championship team? Like how was that chemistry on and off the court as well?
Depends. The early ones, we were with Tony, just knew the first one, and we were just following Tim, David, Steve Kerr, and the guys that played the most. And I was super intimidated by Tim. I couldn't even understand him. And then slowly, five, things started to change. Tony and me started to take up a bigger role. We started to be more vocal, being more comfortable. And I think our biggest advantage was that we just, having played for already now 3-4 years, having won a championship, then the second one, like we knew each other.
Yeah.
And we had that competitive advantage. And then we all trusted each other. We knew what our goals were. Like, it was not about making the All-Star game. It was not about scoring 20. It was about just winning and trying to get one of those. But in the locker room or on the court, just a couple of looks between Pop and Tim, Tim and Tony and me, and Pop with me. So that's things that, time.
Yeah.
Give you. So it was fun. We got a gold medalist group.
See, we're the best duo. The best duo so far.
Yeah, first
two
it was
gold medalists.
That was a different thing, right?
It was incredible. No, for sure. I feel like just being in the locker room and being like, I feel like for me, like I played a lot like in the NBA, and then going and be with those guys that are all-stars and future Hall of Famers, it was almost like I was always in a learning moment. Like I was always trying to learn, always trying to pick their brains and take something that I could bring back here and use. And those guys made a lot of sacrifices. And I that really stuck with me because I was like, well, if they can take this many sacrifices and put it towards the game in FIBA and win a gold medal, what's our excuse when I come here that if I need to take sacrifice or make a sacrifice, why can't I do that in order for us to win games?
When anybody else but the States go to Olympic Games, we got goals, dreams.
Yeah.
But for you guys, it's either win it or it's a frustration, right? And you go defeated home. For us, a bronze medal is something that we look forward to.
Yeah.
If we get more, then it would be awesome. but you know, sacrificing all that time and all the attention that you get and all the responsibilities and go there compete, it takes guts, it takes courage. Well, for you it's completely different because you are being a leader in a team that is kind of new at, how old are you?
23.
Yeah. So you are the veteran in this team, it's crazy. I mean, and I got here at 25, rookie, with, you know, 30 plus year old man.
Yeah.
So I assume it's a completely different experience. I mean, assuming a leadership role at that age, I don't know how you facing that. Do you feel you're ready, or you feel like you know, take it easy. Man, yeah. I need to learn how to.
I feel like I'm definitely ready this year. I feel like last year kind of threw me for a loop. You know, I was put on the forefront to be the leader, be that guy. And I feel like it took a lot of ups and downs, but this year I really feel like, you know, I matured a lot more. I think it's definitely different, you know, different dynamic this year than last year, but I definitely think I'm ready.
It takes time.
Yeah.
And I don't feel like you have to be a leader right away because, you know, you are 23 and you are learning and it's only your fifth year, so you'll grow up. You'll grow up into that role. So, you know, take it easy and don't feel like pushed, even though if the reality is that. But it's fun to see you guys taking that role, and I can already see when you guys play, you and Devin being more vocal and demanding more from your teammates. So it's fun to see, you know, how you are developing, growing into, because it's the necessity of the team, right?
Yeah.
You can see that the new guys kind of look up to you.
Yeah, and that's the crazy part, because I feel like when I first came in, like, we had an older team looking up to LA and DeMar and Patty and having a young point guard like DeJounte. Everything was so much more like, you know, direct because the guys are older. Like they could communicate with each other as just coming straight forward and saying, hey, you missed that. And it's like, all right, bet, like, you know, let's keep it going.
How do you take the different expectations? Is that something that you care about, that excites you, and said, okay, now it's our time?
You know, I put a lot of time in the gym, and my teammates put a lot of time in, and I feel like when you have a group that works hard and wants each other to be successful, good things are bound to happen.
I definitely am a witness that you are putting a lot of work.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think I ever heard of a team that most of the group stay here all summer and do those workshops and work hard and stay here. So that's amazing. And my advice in that regard is just to focus on that, but just support each other because you know the work you're putting in. I'm looking forward to it as a fan. And I see my kids, you know, starting to talk about it and the new jerseys and the players. And so I think the city is gonna be fired up about this and they're gonna be supporting the whole group in a different way.
Definitely.
All right, Keldon.
All right.
Keldonio. That's the San Antonio name for Keldon. Keldonio, so great talking to you, man. I'll be seeing you quite often the next few months.
All right.
So all the best, man. Have a wonderful season.
I got a lawnmower to see. Two is coming.
Two of them.
You have a lawnmower?
Yeah, I got John Deere. That was summertime. Go outside and cut grass.
For me, it was the first time. I mean, I couldn't go straight. I was like going like this.